हेलो फ्रेंड्स, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस। यू हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड फर्स्ट स्टेज फॉर गेटिंग ए बैंक जॉब बाय पासिंग द IBPS कंडक्टेड एग्जामिनेशन। व्हाट हैज बीन योर अचीवमेंट सो फार? यू हैव ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ड that you are better than others. Out of few lakhs which appeared in the examination along with you, you are the one among few thousands now . What is the task ahead, or what is your target? Now your target is to be one among few hundreds, or maybe few tens, and it is not very difficult. Convince yourself that you can do it. You have to do it, and you are going to complete the second stage successfully. Here we are sharing few interview tips with you so that you can perform little better in your interview. So we start with basics of bank job interview. Your interview board may consist of 3 to 5 members from different fields. Remember, the board members are more experienced than you. Hence, no answer which you feel to be false or uncertain should be given. Better to say sorry, so that you are ready for next question. Duration of your interview. Your interview may range from 5 to 15 minutes, depending upon how interesting you can make the interview. It is up to you how interesting you can make the interview. It is not on the interview board members. It is up to you. Number of questions. Here again, only you will decide how many questions will be there. It can be 5 or 20 or even more, depending upon whether you lead the interview or follow the interview. What is going to be scope of your question? The coverage of your questions. The question will be covering your family background, your academic performance, your knowledge, your extracurricular activities, the hobbies you pursue, your knowledge about current affairs, and what not, anything under the sky. There are two approaches for interview. One is called leading the interview, and other is called following the interview. Leading the interview means only you decide what the interview board members should ask you. Follow the interview. Under this approach, you answer those questions which the interview board members will ask you. You you have to decide where you will be more comfortable. And you will be preparing yourself accordingly. Obviously, it would be more comfortable for you to go for A, that is, lead the interview. Now, how to lead the interview? There are steps before the interview. So, proper planning to lead the interview will start while preparing for actual interview, not at the time of interview, but before the actual interview. And the strategy could be something like as under. Prepare your detailed CV and cover your academic, professional experience aspects to understand your strengths and your weaknesses. Make out list of important topics you think will be relevant to your interview. Collect the relevant information or the material. Then memorize it and practice it. And remain focused. Now, steps during the interview. If you want to lead the interview, what steps you have to take during the interview process? While answering the questions, listen the question carefully. Think or pause for 3-4 seconds. Organize what you know and then answer. Do not jump to give answers. While giving answer, you should not speak very loudly, but make sure that you are audible. Your pace should not be very fast. It should be not slow either. At fast pace, others may not be able to understand what you say, and it may create confusion. In addition, there is possibility of more questions being asked. Faster you give a reply to a question, faster you may be getting next question. Now, golden rule to lead the interview. Intentionally, you should try to express such words, phrases, or terms in your answers that may be of interest to the interview board members. If you are able to do this, the board members will start asking you questions about those terms which you have prepared very well and which you have already practiced. So this way, you will be asked only those questions which you have prepared very well, and you are going to lead the interview and make it a memorable event. A very often asked question could be, why you should be selected? try to find an answer to this. Possibly, it could be based on the following: your skills, your experience, your educational qualification should broadly match the requirement of the bank job. You are hardworking and you have the right type of positive attitude. But be ready to quote examples also. You are good at public relations, an important element in service industry like bank. Again, be ready to quote some example. Your strengths in terms of your qualifications or skills or experience must convince you that you can contribute to growth of banking business, and you have to prove that in the interview itself. There are certain attributes which are desirable for a bank job. Let us see what those attributes are. First, empathy, that is understanding of customer needs. Second, knowledge of banking products, knowledge of customer requirements. Accountable, you should be able to hold yourself accountable. Particularly, if something goes wrong, you should be able to own it. Hard work. You should be hard working, ready to put in continuous hours of effort. Rather, little extra effort. Right attitude. You should have positive attitude towards life situations. You should be analytical, you should have professional approach, and you should be information literate. These are some of the desirable attributes for a bank job. Banker may be looking in you certain things. So what do the bankers look in you, search in you during the interview process? Your good academic record, appropriate power of expression, clarity of thought, leadership quality, extracurricular activities, creativity in the form of hobbies. Your overall behavior in different situations. Your communication skills. And overall suitability for the job. That is what the bankers look in you.